Viti. He doesn't leave things to chance.
He's such a good guy with balance and throttle control that even if he gets on the bike and doesn't have a lot of experience with it, it won't take him long to figure it out. Whether it's going to be detrimental to his result tonight, we'll have to see what happens.
Man to keep an eye on tonight, Jonas Kolodziej. Of course, he's in the Grand Prix permanently this year. And there's a lot of good names,
you know,
that are going to be
ahead. Yeah, and this guy right here, he's so light. Man, the guy weighs about 9 stones, wet.
Almost and seems strange to still have Antonio Lim back in the series.
Well, it's great. He's young. He's only like 25
Indeed.
Years old. You
he's
know?
Been
so
around forever, it
yeah,
seems.
Yeah, exactly. And, you know, if he can, he's got itchy fingers at the start. Hopefully he doesn't get himself into trouble.
New man, Artem Laguta, impermanently. So two Russians in this year, although only one Brit.
And he said last year when he qualified for this thing that him and ML Saifut, enough, we're going to actually team up a little bit. And there he is right there, ML. And this guy, if he starts the way he started the previous Grand Prix series and carries on without any injury, he's a bit of a loose cannon sometimes on the racetrack, but on big tracks, fast.
All these guys, as they pass through, though, these are live shots coming from the track, they're all potential Grand Prix winners, unlike past years, I think, in Grand Prix.
Well, Freddie's one of three in this field that I think hasn't won a Grand Prix final. And Nicky Pedersen, three-time world champion, plenty of experience at the top of the game in the Grand Prix series.
Okay, curveball. What other sport can you name me in motorsport where the whole grid is made up of people who can win?
There you go. Great, exciting, yeah. And this guy here is, hopefully resurged his Grand Prix by having a different team around him. He was struggling last year. Chris
this
Holden.
Is a man that really wants to put it together. I mean, he won the British Grand Prix last year, but then it just fell for him in the second half of the season, didn't it?
Yeah, and he's such a good rider, you know. I mean, he's performing day in and day out. We've seen him, do the win the pairs, the British League pairs. Kenneth Bear started off great too, and he's another little guy. You know, I don't think he'll suffer as much with the silencer issue because the silencer does drown the power a little bit.
A lot of pressure, I think, for Chris Harris, or maybe not. He's a man that's used to doing things on his own. Now he's got to do them on his own in Grand Prix.
Yeah, and he's a flat racer, you know, and if this track can produce it, I was surprised when Chris Louie talked about not a lot of dirt.
Papa.
There you go. Greg Hancock. I mean, this guy's, you know, he's a veteran at making starts, and he's been in every one of the Grand Prix. What experience is that going to take for him? We'll soon find out.
Rooney Holter, hand, wrist, and rib injuries.
Yes.
Big off on Monday. So whether this man is fit for tonight, we're going to find out soon. He's walking fairly leisurely. Move to Sweden for Jason. Jason's moved his whole family to Sweden now. That's where he's based. He's moved away from England. You wouldn't bet against that man, though, this year. He's dead fit.
Yeah, he is, and he's got some good equipment, a good team as well.
Yarik Hempel, a bit of a favorite this
year. Yeah, I kind of think this is a track he has a lot of experience on, rode many years here. Another guy that's quietly confident and wants to improve.
Listen to the roar we're going to get here. Tomasz Golub.
Yeah.
During the winter, we've been building up to this moment, the first race of the 2011 World Speedway Championship. The Grand Prix Series gets underway, and what a lineup. Chris Holder off the inside, Tomasz Golub off gate two, the reigning champ. Freddie Lindgren goes off gate three in white. Chris Harris, the sole British rider in the Grand Prix, he goes off the outside in the yellow helmet colour. The nerves will be jangling. It'll be very, very tense out there. The first race of 11 rounds of World Grand Prix Speedway here in Leszno gets underway. And Golub has made a beauty off two. What about Holder in red and sweeping around the outside? Is Harris? Lindgren comes up the inside. It's all very tight down that back straight. What a start to this meeting. Golub, though, under control at the moment. Holder's coming up the inside. Golub has the speed.
Well, he just about. I tell you what, they're queuing up behind him. Brilliant start from gate two from the champion. Holder now settles in second place with Lindgren charging hard in third. Harris did challenge initially, but he's now back in at the back. Golub looks over his shoulder. Holder trying hard in second.
Golub has the lead then. Chris Holder second. Freddie Lindgren is third in white. At the back is Chris Harris. Golub, we wondered how he would get on with the new silencers tonight, because in the Polish league they've been using the
last
the old silencer, absolutely. But look at him go here. He is looking jet-propelled. He's got the race under control, looking smooth, although Holder has got plenty of pace as well down that back straight. But Golub has got the race under control, it seems. Holder tries the inside line, but listen to the roar of the Leszno crowd. The world champion is off to a dream start.
Fabulous start from Tomasz Golub. There's no question he would have been feeling nervous before defending his opening ride to defend his world champion. Look at the reaction down the back straight. That tells you everything. That was superb. A tough opening lap. They were clambering all over one another. But Golub got his nose in front. Held on. Not a comfortable win because Holder was there, but he'll be delighted to get the 3 points.
Well, heat number one, the result then is as follows. Thomas Golub, the race winner. Chris Holder second. Freddie Lindgren was third. Chris Harris training at the back there. Disappointment for the young, the great British rider. As Thomas Golub, back of the race jacket, it's actually a corresponding with the colour of the helmet.
Nice touch.
Absolutely. Heat number two, Jonas Kolodze going off the inside. Gate two is Andreas Johnsen. Mikki Pedersen, triple world champion, goes off gate three in white. Rune Holter going off the outside in yellow. Rune, though, injured on Monday in the Polish League. Jason Crum watching on. I just wonder how Rune Holter will fare. Struggled in practice, cut his practice short yesterday.
Yes, he did, yeah.
Because of the injuries he sustained in the Polish League on Monday. Heat number two. Craig Aykroyd is taking charge of the Grand Prix tonight. His first Grand Prix. And away from the start, a good start for the man in red, Kolodze. Pedersen is diving up the inside. It's all very tight there. And
Holter
around the outside. Rune Holter winding it on. And he's going wide now. But Kolodze looking very quick here in red. Pedersen is third now with Johnsen at the back. But going into lap two, Jonas Kolodze looking very quick here.
Smart away from the tapes on the inside. Kolodze swept around that first corner. Got to say that Holter looked like he might have been able to get round the outside, but then cut back to the inside, cutting the nose off of the three-time champ Pedersen, who now lies in third place. Johnsen, who was so quick yesterday, has tailed off a wee bit in fourth. But Kolodze, no surprise for me, fast out in front.
Jonas Kolodze, who has only ridden in three Grand Prix before this particular meeting, and has won four Grand Prix races before now, and is looking as though he's very assured, very steady, and has got this race well and truly in the bag. Jonas Kolodze then, in the red helmet colour, second place in yellow, Rune Holter, third goes to Mikki Pedersen.
Wow.
Training at the back, Andreas Johnsen, and Leshno goes wild.
Back-to-back wins for the Poles in the first two races, and dead right, the fans are on their feet. Kolodze, of course, the local boy, fast away from the inside, and fast to victory in heat two. Kolodze, no question, will be a threat. Made the final, of course, here last year, and he knows what it's all about.
Yep, Jonas Kolodze, no major surprise when he was selected as a pick, if you like, for the Grand Prix this year. Kolodze the winner with Rune Holter second, Mikki Pedersen was third, and Andreas Johnsen trailing at the back, and there'll be a good mood in the camp there. Krzysztof Sojelski with him there, the former rider, and Mikki Pedersen.
Career, he was fast yesterday, there's no doubt about it, there's a huge potential with the young Russian.
Many experts saying it's the best ever Grand Prix lineup. Every race, an absolutely mouth-watering prospect. Saifudinov going off the inside in the red helmet. Got on the rostrum in his first year as a GP rider. Jarek Campbell going off gate two. Watch him go here tonight on a track he loves. Greg Hancock, the veteran, going off gate three in white. The only ever present in the GP. And Kenneth Pierre is going off the outside gate in the yellow helmet colour. Made a good start to the series last year.
Yeah.
Saifudinov back, fully fit and raring to go.
Indeed he is. Kenneth Pierre, of course, was superb at the beginning of last year. He's on the outside. Can he do something special? Not easy coming from the outside. It's a long way to the first turn from there.
Craig Aykroyd has his finger on the button and the tape tries. And away. Good start from Hancock in white. But what about that from Emil Saifudinov in red? Now Hancock's charging around the outside. Coming through in blue is Hampel. Hampel charging hard up the inside. The lead, though, so far is with a talented young Russian, Emil Saifudinov. Charging through into second now. Jarek Hampel. Pierre is working hard to come into third. And Hancock has been squeezed to the back. And now Pierre.
Oh! Clips his front wheel down the back straight. Hampel comes off big time. Red lights, no doubt, will come on.
They are on. The race
Hampel,
is stopped.
They're just getting contact there. No real malice from Pierre, just hard charging. Hampel had gone wide and had left himself vulnerable coming off the second corner for the second time. Pierre dived up the instigator to the back. We see it again. Pierre just in the middle of the track and Hampel was unsure which way to go. Look, he makes trying to make a decision and just decides to go to the inside and clips his back wheel. A misjudgment from the Polish rider.
Well, Craig Aykroyd with his first big decision in charge of the Grand Prix tonight. And you suspect after the incident?
High-speed accident, though, Nigel. Speed
absolutely
there, coming off that banking down that back straight. Certainly would have been a shock to the system, no question.
Well, it's almost the fastest part of the track.
Looks like he's excluded Pierre.
Kenneth Pierre has gone. The yellow exclusion light is on. And Kenneth Pierre will not be allowed back in the rerun.
Looked to me initially when I was watching in real time that actually Hampel just was looking for a way through and just ran in the back of him. Admittedly, Bierre was slow coming off the corner, but he was in front of Hampel. Hampel kind of ran into him. No malice there. Difficult decision, admittedly, but Bierre will be furious with that. A difficult call, no question.
Hampel Seyfudinov goes off the inside. Yarek Hampel is off gate two. Greg Hancock is going off gate number three. And Hancock initially was pushing hard for second place, then he was relegated to the back, and it was developing into a feral battle there.
It was, and he just got himself in the wrong position at the wrong time and got squeezed out. You can't move too far off the line at this stage. They settle down, here we go.
Heat number three, the rerun. The green light is on, and Seyfudinov makes a dream start again. Hancock now will try and whip up the inside. Here comes Hampel in blue, but Seyfudinov has the lead now, and Greg Hancock has come through into second place. Yarek Hampel is third, maybe feeling the effects of that crash just a few moments ago. But Emil Seyfudinov going into lap number two, looking superb, although Hancock is quick so far.
Brilliant stuff from the American there on the opening lap. A smart move to make sure he tucked to the inside to cover that move from Hampel. And reproducing the start for Seyfudinov out in front. Beginning to stretch his legs now, Nigel. Certainly settling out in front. And this is the sort of speed I witnessed yesterday at practice. Always fast.
Yep, Emil Seyfudinov, a talented young rider. Also rides in his home country for Balakovo in the Russian League. And now, the man at the back, third place, Yarek Hampel, still trying to gain ground. But Hancock's looking good in second place. There's Seyfudinov, very smooth, very stylish, and surely in with a chance of the rostrum again this year. Takes the chequered flag. Second place goes to Greg Hancock, and third place goes to Yarek Hampel. But Seyfudinov had to make two starts there, and he responded, and the pressure was on second time around. Look what it means to him, punching the air. He will be delighted with that. Back in the GP after that horrendous injury campaign last year. His season was wrecked by injury, and it's great to see him back on a bike and absolutely flying here. Seyfudinov the winner. Hancock from the USA was second. Yarek Hampel was third. And so far, race wins for Tomasz Golub, Jonas Kolodze, and Emil Seyfudinov. He will win red. It's Antonio Limbach. Good to see him back at his best. He goes off the inside here. Damian Belinsky, the Lechno rider, plenty of support here, goes off too. Artem Laguta will be nervous. He is making his first full appearance as a GP rider. And going off the outside is Jason Crump in yellow, three times world champion. Will he be back and challenging again this time around? Heat number four. After this race, every rider will have completed one ride. And what about that from Crump off the outside? Sweet as you like. Oh, but coming up hard up the inside in red was Antonio Limbach. And now in blue, really working hard, Damian Belinsky, the home rider. Laguta's at the back. But that was brilliant from Jason Crump. The way he swept across and all his experience coming to the fore. And a real battle for second spot here. Oh, really working hard is Antonio Limbach in red. And the man in blue, Damian Belinsky.
Yeah, Belinsky was under enormous pressure there, but it's killed the speed of Limbach, and all of a sudden Laguta's now in the picture. But what a superb start, the first rider to do anything from the outside, sweeping round the outside. Jason Crump fast out in front. Belinsky settled nicely in second place. Can be quite an unpredictable rider. I've seen him ride in the past. Fireworks for sure sometimes from him. Out in front, Crump looks world class.
He does. He's looking very quick. Absolutely right. He's won 22 Grand Prix in his career, and he is absolutely dominating this race. Jason Crump is back, and big time. Second place in blue, Damian Belinsky. Third, Antonio Limbach. Artem Laguta starts his Grand Prix career with a last place there. But Jason Crump, the way he swept across.
Brilliant stuff from
gate four.
Brilliant stuff from Crump from the outside, no doubt about that. Had the confidence, had the belief in his bike that he would generate enough speed to roar around the outside.
Here's your result of heat four then. Jason Crump the winner, with Damian Belinsky the wild card second place. Third was Antonio Limbach, and trailing in at the back was Artem Laguta. Every rider has now completed one ride, and we see the race winners so far: Golub, Crump, Seyfudinov and Kolodze. And that was predictable really in many ways.
The first four races have given all 16 riders a taste of Lechno. Who's your money on? Still a long way to go for round one. Stay with us. We'll take a break. Will Jason?
Of the European Speedway Grand Prix live here In Leszno, Poland, as we see Jason Krump going off the inside in the red helmet colour. Very impressive win first time out. Chris Holder is off gate two, rides for the Pool Pirates in the British Elite League. Yanis Kolodze goes off gate three in white. And off the outside, Greg Hancock. Two race winners in gates one and three here. But this type of field, tough to predict. But with Krump off one, if he can make a start like he did off four last time out, he should fancy his chances here.
Yeah, I would think so, although the danger man potentially could well be Kolodze. Gate 3 is not ideal and not the easiest place to win from, but he's the sort of guy that can generate a lot of speed. Of course, Krump was mightily impressive and very fast indeed in his opening ride. It's all about getting off the first corner on the inside for Krump, no question.
Heat number 5 it is then. Craig Aykroyd with his finger on the button. Green light is on. And the tapes rise, and it's a beauty from Chris Holder in blue, but sweeping around the outside, Greg Hancock. Absolutely brilliant from Hancock. Krump is second, Holder third, Kolodze now charging through, trying to get through into third place, but the old master, Greg Hancock, an ever-present in the Grand Prix since it started in 1995, has just pulled off a magnificent move from the outside gate position. Greg Hancock, the only American in the lineup. What a ride, keeping Jason Krump at bay. Chris Holder is pushing Krump hard now as well, with Kolodze somewhat surprisingly trailing at the back.
Fabulous stuff from Hancock around that first corner. The contact between Holder and Krump did him a bit of a favour, but he was there ready to pounce. Hancock fast out in front. Krump and Holder really going at it for second and third. Surprisingly, Kolodze's out of the back. One lap to go. Hancock looking strong out in front.
He is indeed, and Hancock didn't have the very best first half of last season. But the 40-year-old is starting this year well. He's pulled off a victory. Greg Hancock in yellow. Second place with Jason Krump. Third in blue was Chris Holder. And trailing at the back, Yanis Kolodze. But Hancock, my word, what a performance.
Fabulous.
Gate number four. You
superb.
Can't substitute experience.
No, you cannot. And certainly there was an issue there on the inside. A little bit of contact between Holder and Krump. And a nice, smooth run around the outside for Greg Hancock. Three valuable points for him.
Yep, Hancock is the race winner then. Second place there went to Jason Krump. And here we see the scores now after two rides for those guys. Krump and Hancock on 5 points out of six, and Kolodze and Holder on 3 points apiece. Remember, it's all about getting in the top eight, and Hancock a happy man, quite rightly so.
Yeah, and he made the most
title with a fantastic victory off gate number two. Here, he's off three, Belinsky off the inside, Emil Saifuddinov off gate two, Tomasz Golubov gate three, and Nicky Pedersen off the outside, two world champions off the outside two gates.
Yeah, hugely competitive race. Once again, all of them are, to be perfectly honest. There's no doubt about that. We'll be very interested to see how Emil Saifuddinov and Golub get on. Of course, they clashed big time in Melilla in Sweden last year when Saifuddinov got injured for the second time and ruled him out of the World Championship. Golub out of the gate three position. That's tough. What can he do?
Heat number six it is. What a lineup. This promises to be fun and games.
Oh, moving on the inside.
Damian Belinsky, the red lights have now come on. The red lights are on. So they're going to have
Golub
to
Golub would be
again.
Absolutely furious
He's
about
angry.
That.
He's an angry man.
No doubt. He made a fabulous start. He's gesturing to the referee down the back straight. Belinsky on the inside just had a bit of a... The tone set a marker for the season for sure.
The restart of Heat 6 then. Damian Belinsky off the inside. Emil Saifuddinov going off gate 2. Tomasz Golub going off gate 3. Nicky Pedersen, three times world champion. He's going off the outside gate. Nicky had an injury hit campaign himself last year, remember? And he needs a clear run of injuries this time around. World champion in 03, 07 and 08. And Nicky, 34 years old now. Belinsky will be nervous on his home track.
No doubt. And he is certainly an erratic rider at times. He can be very spectacular. No question, and it's a huge night for him, his debut in the Grand Prix, and particularly on his home track. They settle down for the restart. Pedersen just delaying things slightly, just going through his ritual there, making sure everything's exactly as he wanted. They're all in line now.
Watch out for Golub again in white. Can he make the start? Can he take that lead? Great start from Golub in white. That was simply textbook. Belinsky's in red. Pedersen in yellow is coming hard around the outside. Nicky Pedersen is on the pace, but Golub is looking like the master. Now Pedersen pushes him hard on the inside. Third place in the red helmet colour is Belinsky. Saifudinov is charging hard on the inside now. Saifudinov coming through, not quite. Belinsky's held him out. Look at this for a battle for third. And Pedersen is on the pace, pushing Tomasz Golub.
Very much so. Brilliant stuff from Golub initially out of gate three. He's out in front, but Pedersen so very fast in second place, all over him. Golub
here
is vulnerable.
Pedersen.
Pedersen's round the outside, down the back straight. Golub pushes him wide. Superb action out in front.
Well, he's going high and trying to get the drive. Golub holds his line. Now Pedersen's going to try the inside line. Nicky Pedersen. Oh, Golub's gone down. Drama here in Leszno. Tomasz Golub has hit the deck and the red lights have come on. This is high sporting drama in only the sixth race of the new season. And Pedersen was quick. Pedersen was very, very quick.
Indeed he was, and Pedersen had the run on Golub going into the first corner, no question about it. Golub was the one that had to move, and he comes round. Pedersen was there in front of him. Golub then tried to react and close the door too late and bites the dust. Look, Pedersen is in front of him. Golub tries to come across and squeeze him up, and there's no room, and he bites the dust. For me, it's another tough call, but for me, Golub should go.
Craig Aykroyd is having a very interesting Grand Prix debut here. The man from Preston in Lancashire has got his finger on the button, and straight away Nicky was waving. Exclusion light is on, and Tomasz Golub has been excluded from the restart. And really, it's hard to argue against that. It's a brave decision from Craig Aykroyd in Poland, in Golub's home country. He's the man to go. But you're quite right, Kelvin, the replays show that Pedersen had taken the lead.
Yeah, Pedersen had the run on him. There's no doubt that Golub was struggling out in front, didn't have the pace. Pedersen was supremely fast coming off turn four.
Pedersen had in that second restart. The chances are perhaps a little on the slim side, but let's go back to the track.
Pedersen looked very, very fast. He goes off the outside. He finished third in his first race behind Holter and Kolodze. But obviously he's weighed the situation up, done something to increase his speed.
I think they were a little bit uncertain about the track. The track has looked grippier than it actually is. May just have changed the gear ratio just to generate a bit more speed. Certainly that was the case in the second time of asking in this race. Third time of asking as you ride this Saver Heat 6. Saifudinov's ready, the other two aren't. Belinsky and Pedersen taking their time. Belinsky, Pedersen, the three of them now beginning to settle down.
Heat number six it is, three riders only then here. Take tries, and
what
Pedersen
a
has
start.
Been left. Saifudinov was magnificent there, and a real challenge for Nicky Pedersen now in the yellow helmet colour. Saifudinov has that lead on a new bike, remember. Nicky Pedersen charging up the inside now. Third place is Belinsky, but Saifudinov made an absolute dream start there in the blue helmet colour, and this is going to test Pedersen. He got the better of Golub. Can he do it from the back with Saifudinov?
How often do we see it when a rider's trailing at the back, the red lights come on, he takes full advantage of the rerun. Out in front, look at that bike go. What a good move that was from the pit crew to put him onto the number two bike, flying out in front. Just as impressive as he was first time out. Pedersen giving chase in second place, but can do nothing about the fast Russian Saifudinov.
Yep, it's only Saifudinov's 16th Grand Prix tonight here in Leszno, and has got this race under control. Pedersen can't catch him. That's how fast Saifudinov is, because Pedersen had the speed on Golub previously, but he can't stop Saifudinov. And it's Emil Saifudinov who takes the checkered flag in Heat 6. Brilliant ride from the young Russian.
Superb stuff from Saifudinov. So jet-propelled away from the start. Not renowned for his starting ability there, but absolutely sharp as a nail there. Absolutely brilliant away from the tapes. And once he had hit the front, he generated more and more speed. Pedersen could do nothing about it. Still good points for Pedersen, but Saifudinov, another valuable 3 points for him.
Yeah, the win was Saifudinov. Second place, Pedersen, will be disappointed that he couldn't win after taking that lead when Golub was excluded. And this is what it means now to the overall standings. And Saifudinov is the only rider unbeaten on 6 points out of a possible six. And Crump and Hancock on five apiece. But that, yeah.
As is Jarek Hempel.
Saifudinov, the second youngest rider in the series, finished third here last year, remember. As we move on to heat number seven, Yara Campbell going off the inside. A big race for all four of these riders.
Yeah.
Antonio Lind back off two. Jonsson off gate three. Not a point to his name so far. And his fellow Swede Lindgren off the outside in yellow.
Yeah, and Lindgren will be expecting better this time. He's been in good form. He wants a big Grand Prix. Jonsson disappointing first time. Can he reproduce something special now?
Heat number seven it is, and Jonsson's made a much better start off gate number three. Lindgren around the outside in yellow. Here comes Freddie Lindgren in the yellow helmet colour, and it's all very tight down that back straight. Charging now is Hampel in red, but Jonsson comes up the inside. Hampel has to square off the bike, and now
Lind back into second place. Battling so very hard with Jonsson, the two Swedes. Now Hampel's back in the third place. Action personified. Hampel down the back straight, trying to get up the inside of Jonsson. Jonsson goes wide, force wide. Hampel in the middle of the track. Lindback back in the action. Throw a blanket over second, third and fourth. Meanwhile, out in front, fast Freddie Lindgren away with it. He's absolutely charging. Superb action at second and third.
Yep, absolutely. Andreas Jonsson is second, but watch out for Yara Campbell in red. He's turning it on and really working hard. Lindback now is trailing at the back. Fast Freddie Lindgren is in the lead now. Andreas Jonsson is second. Third place in red is Yara Campbell. Lindback at the back. It looks as though that's the way it's going to stay now, with Lindgren getting the victory. Andreas Jonsson second. Yara Campbell was third, and 4 points from two rides for Hampel so far. But Lindgren from the outside, absolutely, he looked
fabulous,
very fast.
And I just wonder whether the added experience of racing on the new Silence and they paid big dividends. His bike was fast. The other three have had little experience of racing on the new setup and were tailed off. Lindgren certainly took full advantage of all the shenanigans that were going on behind him. Brilliant stuff, entertaining stuff, but Lindgren will be delighted.
Jonsson second, Yara Campbell was third, Antonio Lindback at the back. And these are the standings now. Lindgren moves on to 4 points from two rides. Jonsson and Hampel on 2 points apiece. So a picture emerging here with Seyfudinov dominating the meeting so far, but Lindgren...
He needs a big performance now with only four rides to count. Holter was impressive with a good solid second place.
Chris Harris going off the inside then, yet to score. Rune Holter going off gate number two. Gate three is Kenneth Pierre and Artem Laguta off the outside. Three of the four riders then yet to score a point between them here.
Yeah, and certainly at this early stage, a lot of pressure on the three of them. So they settle down.
Heat number eight it is then. Harris, the man in red, desperate for a good result here, but what a start from Holter. And now Harris has charged up the inside, but now Holter in blue, and round the outside comes Kenneth Pierre. He's very fast down that back straight. Kenneth Pierre into turns three and four, comes around the outside of Rune Holter. That is a fantastic ride from Kenneth Pierre. Holter is second, Harris is third, and Artem Laguta is at the back.
Fabulous stuff from Kenneth Pierre. This is what we've been witnessing back in the UK. He's been fast so far this season. Brilliant down the back straight. Looked like Holter had it in the bag, but Holter got caught napping a wee bit going into turns three and four on the opening lap. Pierre out in front. Holter now beginning to give chase. Disappointing once again from Harris, not really showing really good speed back in third place.
Holter is looking very quick. He's making ground on Pierre going into the last lap. Pierre had bike problems in the Elite League pairs in England on Wednesday for Kings Lynn Stars, but he's looking good here. But he's just got a bit more work to do, because Holter is going to go high around the outside, try and get the drive, but Pierre's done enough. Kenneth Pierre the winner, second place in blue, Rune Holter. Third was Chris Harris, and that was a fine ride from Kenneth Pierre.
Super stuff from Kenneth Pierre, showed really good composure there. It was a disappointing start to tonight's meeting, failing to score, being excluded, and he can do no more than come out in his second ride and pick up the big 3 points. And
Grand Prix in Leszno, Poland, drama and determination Prix as the sun drops down behind the horizon. This is how it looks. 6 points then for Emil Seyfudinov, five for Jason Crump, Greg Hancock, four is for Freddie Lindgren, Rune Holter, Thomas Golob only three, Kenneth Pierre likewise with three, and Kolodziej as well doing a quiet job in the top eight. Let's hear then live from Chris Lewis.
It's Grand Prix of his career tonight, so Gothenburg in a fortnight will be a milestone 100th Grand Prix for Nicky Pedersen. He goes off the inside. Gate two is Artem Laguta on his debut tonight in the Grand Prix series. Chris Holder goes off gate three. Yara Campbell disappointed to only score 2 points so far He's off the outside gate. It'll be interesting to see if he can do what Lindgren and what Crump have done and come off the outside and secure a victory. This is heat number 9 of the European Grand Prix. And away from the start, Nicky Pedersen off gate number 1 has made a good one. Charging around the outside in white is Chris Holder. Pedersen holds his line superbly. Hampel charging through now into third place and putting pressure on Chris Holder. Laguta at the back is really fighting hard. Pedersen has the lead, but he's under all sorts of pressure from Chris Holder, and Hampel will keep it working hard as well.
Fabulous lap and a half of speed there. Nicky Pedersen beginning to stamp his authority on the race. Did remarkably well to hang on out in front, coming away from the inside. Pedersen looking good. Holder charging hard. Hampel once again struggling for points. He's giving it everything he's got, but he just is not quite fast enough. Pedersen, meanwhile, looking good out in front, showing great concentration and good speed.
Yeah, Pedersen looking very quick here. An injury-ravaged campaign rides for Korzhov here in Poland. That's where the final Grand Prix of the year will be, and the Speedway World Cup as well this summer. Nicky Pedersen looking very impressive. He's going to take his first win of the new Grand Prix campaign. Nicky Pedersen from Chris Holder, from Jari Kampel, Artem Laguta trailing at the back, still looking for his first point as a Grand Prix rider, but Pedersen will be absolutely delighted with that. Smashing. Looking good for a semi-final.
Yeah, really place. Good stuff from Pedersen, no question about that. We saw some speed earlier on when he challenged Golub as they went into the first corner for the third time, and he looked fast then, and once again, heat 9, he comes up with the big 3 points. Impressive from the three-time champ.
Pedersen the winner with Chris Holder in second place, moves him on to 5 now, with Hampel third. Pedersen moves on to 6 from 3 rides, so Saifudinov still has a race in hand on him. Holder on 5 points now, and surprisingly, Jari Kampel only 3. He'll be wound up, you can be sure of that. Here's the lineup. Kenneth Bier off the inside. Can he carry that speed forward from his last outing? Jonas Kolodze, 3 points so far. He goes off gate 2. Antonio Lindbeck back in the Grand Prix series, finding it a little bit tough tonight. He's off 3. Tomasz Golub, the reigning world champion, is going off the outside in the yellow helmet colour. Here we go with heat number 10, and it's a good start from the man in blue, Jonas Kolodze. Watch out for Golub now, sweeping around the outside. Sensational ride from Tomasz Golub. Second place is Jonas Kolodze. Battle for third place right now. Antonio Lindbeck holds it. Bier comes up the inside, though, and Kenneth Bier has got third place, but that was vintage Tomasz Golub.
Fabulous first corner from Golub. He came under a lot of pressure, really had to wind it on around the outside. He's now got his nose in front. Kolodze settles in second place. Bier, so impressive last time out, really having to find something special in third place. Lindbeck struggling out the back, but look at Golub. This is more like it, stretching his legs down that back straight, pulling away.
Well, if he wins this, that'll be the 2 wins out of the 2 races he's finished. He was excluded in his last outing, and he's going into the last lap with the race under control, on his way to 6 points out of a possible 9. Second place in blue is Jonas Kolodze. Kenneth Bier is third in red, and trailing at the back is Antonio Lindbeck. But Tomasz Golub takes the chequered flag and absolutely delighted as he just really shows how passionate he is. Beats his chest as he goes over.
Showing plenty of heart there as he finished the race. Slowed down. A glare at the referees. He went over the line to win that race. 6 points out of a possible 9. The world champion right back in the thick of things.
Yeah, superb ride from Tomasz Golub. Heat number 10, the official result. Golub the winner. Jonas Kolodze was second. Kenneth Bier was third. Lindbeck at the back. And a perfect way for Golub to bounce back and put himself right bang in contention for a semi-final place. 6 points from 3 rides. Kolodze is on 5 now. Bier out of the top 8 picture at the moment on 4 points so far. But Golub.
And of course, more points, you get a better draw for the semis.
Heat number 11 it is then, with Rune Holter going off the inside. Greg Hancock off gate 2. Gate 3 in white is Fredrik Lindgren, a winner last time out, and Damian Bilinski is going off the outside. Heat number 11 coming up, and Hancock still going strong. As we mentioned tonight, a winner last time out. Richard Child, the USA manager, Greg Hancock, pick corner, Jason Crump watching on. And a big heat number 11 coming up for all 4 of these riders, because remember, you have to get in that top 8 And this is the third outing for each of these riders. Heat number 11, the pressure is on. Away from the start in blue, Greg Hancock. A dream start for him, a trademark Hancock start, that one. Belinsky comes up the inside in yellow, but Lindgren has got second place right now. Rune Halter is trailing at the back. Lindgren goes high and wide. Hancock's got the race under control right now. Lindgren really getting close to Hancock, though. Third place at the moment is Belinsky, and trailing at the back is Rune Halter, but Lindgren is starting to work Greg Hancock.
Fabulous start for Hancock out of gate two, but there's no doubt about it that Lindgren is very fast in second place. Squares the corner off, looking for a way through. Switches back to the outside now, trying to generate more speed. Hancock's going to have to go for it here. Lindgren is charging hard.
This is a good race developing here. Greg Hancock has the lead. Lindgren switches up the inside once again. Has Lindgren got the speed? They're going into the last lap. Super speedway race here. Battle at the back as well, with Belinsky just holding on to third. Lindgren now is going to have to go some in the final turn, three and four. Hancock goes wide. Lindgren tries the inside line. Hancock, though, has just enough.
Good speed where Halter snatches third place on the run to the line. Passing Belinsky coming out of the last corner. Real big heart shown by Halter once again to get amongst the points on the run to the line. Super action out in front with Hancock hanging on. And a super effort there from Freddie Lindgren in second place. Good speedway, no doubt about that. Got to say that the veteran American is really going for it tonight. Sensational away from the tapes.
That's his second race win. Greg Hancock with Lindgren in second place. Really worked hard there, tried to get after him. Rune Halter in third, and Damian Belinsky at the back. Super speedway race, and Hancock moves on to 8 points, leads the Grand Prix now. Freddie Lindgren in the top eight, fifth place on six. Halter is on five, and Belinsky on 3 points. He's known as the Grin. There'll be a big grin on his face.
Super stuff. Right.
Big race for all four of these riders. Heat number 12. After this race, every rider in the field will have completed three of their five rides. Crump goes off the inside. Chris Harris is off gate two. Emil Seifert in off gate three. Two out of two so far. Jonsson off the outside. This is heat number 12 and a big race. And it's a great start from Chris Harris in blue. Harris has hit that first turn. A dream start for the Great Britain rider. Now has he got the speed to see off the opposition? Coming through into second place now is Emil Seifuddinov. And Seifuddinov is diving up the inside of Chris Harris. And Harris just holds that lead.
Krupp's got to the back.
Into second now. And Krupp at the back. This is a great race. Watch for Seifuddinov in white. He's really piling on the pressure now. And Chris Harris is under all sorts of pressure. Calvin.
Three abreast going into turn three for the second time. Harris out in front, but only just. Jonsson up the inside. Seifuddinov hanging on for second place. Krupp unbelievably relegated to the back. Now Jonsson gets into second place. Superb action. Harris, meanwhile, out in front, hanging on.
He just about managed to pull clear in that last lap. Chris Harris there into the final lap of heat number 12. And this could be a massive, massive result for Chris Harris.
He look at Seifuddinov on the inside of the last corner. Charges into second place. Incredible action for second place.
Seifuddinov gets second.
Wow.
Anders Jonsson and Jason Krupp relegated to the back. Chris Harris of Great Britain pulls off a magnificent win in heat number 12. Digging deep, really working hard. And remember, he'd only got 1 point to his name before then. But the only Great Britain man in the lineup has just done him and his nation proud.
Well, the change of equipment there comes to the rescue for Chris Harris. Brilliant start and a brilliant ride. Seifuddinov was absolutely sensational in his second place. Ruthless down the back straight on the last lap to dive underneath Jonsson. Of course, both those two boys last year were teammates at Bidgos, but no love lost there. Superb action.
Seifuddinov second now, level on 8 points with Hancock. Krump on five. Harris just outside the top eight, and Jonsson only on 3 points now.
Today's route to the final in Leszno is still wide open, despite the track not being the best today. Talk about in tonight's Grand Prix so far, none less than it's Greg Hancock and Emil Seifuddinov tied on 8 points. And behind them, Thomas Golob, back after that disqualification with a race win last time out in Heat 10. Nicky Pedersen's there also, so's Freddie Lindgren. Jason Krupp, bit of a problem for him, finishing last in his last heat out there. Five with Kolodzi, and Chris Holder is in eighth place at the moment. So let's go back to the track, live of course with Chris Louie, who has Chris Harris with him.
Heat 13, we're off and running once again then after the interval here in Leszno. Andreas Jonsson off the inside, big race, 3 points so far. Kenneth Bierre under pressure on four. Belinsky to wild card off gate three on 3 points. Chris Holder from Australia going off the outside with 5 points to his name.
Yeah, key ride for all four riders here. They're not really having the best of nights. Holder, of course, has shown plenty of speed. Needs to get around that first corner and really power down the back straight. But Jonsson on the inside, what can he do?
Heat number 13 it is. And the tape rise and away from the start. It's a good one from Pierre in the blue helmet colour. Holder coming around the outside. Oh, he's getting all the
way.
Belinsky has gone down in the white helmet colour. Is he going to stay down? No, he's up and about, and the race continues. He's not going to... The red light is now on, and Belinsky is back on his bike and about to clear the track.
Yep, I called him Kolodze, so I got that completely wrong, but Belinsky certainly running up the side of Kenneth Pierre there, getting it all wrong and then slipping off. He was up and about, and possibly the red lights didn't need to come on, but they have, and it'll be Belinsky, I'm sure, that'll get excluded. Yes, the white exclusion light is on. Disappointment for him. He's in front of his home crowd, of course, but just got himself in a little bit of trouble there, and possibly Holder coming hard across from the outside. It got all very tight as they went through that first turn. They haven't managed to win races, so well, Pierre's won a race, but it's been up and down, with the exclusion making life a little bit more difficult. But 3, 4, and 5 points respectively, a win would be very useful.
Jonsson off the inside then, Kenneth Pierre going off gate two, no rider off three, Belinsky excluded. Going off the outside is Chris Holder of Australia. As you said, Kelvin, very, very fast, Chris Holder, in his first ride. The first attempt to stage this race, I should say.
Oh, brilliant round the first corner, and they've graded the track, and there's plenty of grip in the middle of the track. He'll be trying to reproduce that sort of start first turn once again.
Heat 13 of the European Grand Prix here in Lesno. And Pierre has made a good one again, so has Chris Holder, but Pierre has held the line. Holder has to go wide, but Pierre, that is a superb ride from Kenneth Pierre in blue. Andreas Jonsson on the pace, trying to come through for second, but Chris Holder has closed the door. The lead is with Kenneth Pierre. Chris Holder second, Andreas Jonsson third, and that was a fantastic first lap from Kenneth Pierre.
Sharp start away from gate two, and this time Holder was good away from the tapes, but lifted halfway out and killed his momentum. Pierre now in front. Roaring high and wide, Holder giving chase. He's not far away, you know, Holder. He's going to have to keep it wound on. Pierre cannot afford to relax at any stage. Jonsson once again struggling back in third place. Good race out in front between Pierre and Holder.
Chris Holder's going to have a real go here. He's wound up. He's really determined. Every point could be vital here in the race for the semi-finals. Kenneth Pierre has that lead. Chris Holder is looking very quick. He's gaining ground. Oh, almost clipped the back wheel of Pierre there. Now he's going high into the dirt to try and get the drive. Down to the finish line we go. And Kenneth Pierre has ridden a lovely line.
Smart
great ride from Pierre.
Smart last turn there from Kenneth Pierre. Holder did a super job in second place, but tried there right round the outside, but just too far with Pierre being able to hold that line in the middle of the track and powered his way to a very useful 3 points and onto 7 points in total. Looking good for the top eight tonight, Kenneth Pierre. Good stuff from him. Holder battling hard in second place.
Yep, good ride from Holder. Jonsson was third. He needed more than that, Andreas Jonsson. This is how it looks now. Pierre and Holder on 7 points apiece, in with a great chance of the semi-finals. Jonsson is only on four and could... Terrific lineup indeed. Heat 14, hang on to the edge of your seats. Thomas Golub off the inside, Jason Crump off two, Rune Holter going off gate three, Yara Campbell under pressure, only on 3 points. He's off the outside in yellow. This is a massive heat 14. And away from the start, Jason Crump's made a beauty, but Thomas Golub holds that line. Coming around the outside, Hampel, absolutely sensational. Crump is second now. Golub working hard in third, and now chasing hard as well. Golub coming through in the red helmet colour. He's putting Crump under pressure. Crump switches up the inside. Sensational race. Amigo is with Hampel.
Unbelievable speedway. Hampel's out in front. Golub's gone from first to last to second in a lap and a half of speedway. Crump's out the back. Incredible stuff on the lap. First two laps. Look at Hampel go out in front. Golub now settles in second place. Crump unbelievably is out the back, putting pressure on Ronnie Holter. But this is more like it from the number two in the world, Hampel, flying out in front. Brilliant speedway.
He needs a win here. Nothing less than a win will do for Hampel. And he really is riding superbly. Golub is second under pressure, though, here from Rune Holter. Into turns three and four they go for the final time. Yarek Hampel raises the roof. Fantastic win in yellow. Second place was Thomas Golub. Runa Holter was third, Jason Crump at the back, and that was the race of the night.
Brilliant stuff there in heat 14 by the top four in the world. No doubt about it. What was Golov doing? He made a brilliant start. He went from first to last to second in the first lap and a half. Hempel, though, that's more like it. Brilliant.
Yarrick Hempel pulling off a result in heat 14 there, then over Thomas Golov, Rooney Holter, and remarkably, for the second time in a row, Jason Crump out the back. Sam Ramolenko, not exactly what you might have expected from the man third in the championship last year.
No, that's right. And I was expecting more out of Yarrick Hempel to come good earlier in this competition. And he's left a little bit late, but at least he's in the top eight at the moment on 6 points.
Golov joins the top two men now then. So Golov is up with Hancock and Hempel on the year and in the point scores. That's how it looks at the moment for him. And that's the lineup right now.
Off the best rider on display consistently tonight, 8 points, and off the outside in yellow, Yanis Kolodze. And Lindgren's made a good start off gate number two. Now on the inside, coming hard is Seifudinov, and Lindgren has gone to third.
Around
the outside, Kolodze. Lindgren now charging hard around to try and get second spot from Seifudinov. Terrific speedway here. The lead though is with Kolodze. Lindgren second. Watch out for Seifudinov. Oh, how on earth did he miss him there?
I really don't know, because Lindgren's now in the second place. Kolodze under attack initially there from Seifudinov. Seifudinov had to really put a locker to make sure he didn't sideswipe him. Look at Seifudinov diving up the inside. Lindgren round the outside in second place. Kolodze looking good out in front. Chasing hard is Lindgren. Keep your eyes on him.
Yeah, Lindgren is going high and wide. He's trying to try on the inside line now on Yanis Kolodze, the local hero here in Lezhno. Kolodze has the lead, but Lindgren is all over him now in the latter stages of another dramatic speedway race here. Lindgren goes wide. Kolodze has locked up the inside. That's a fantastic ride from Kolodze. Lindgren, very, very close from Lindgren. And Seifudinov was third. And I don't know about you, Kelvin, but with Seifudinov third there, I think this Grand Prix is wide open.
Indeed it is. And there's no doubt that Seifudinov very nearly just took out Kolodze there as he charged up the inside. How on earth did he miss him? Kolodze was brilliant out in front. Very smart last corner to cover the move from the faster Freddie Lindgren back in second place. Sensational speedway. The Grand Prix has come alive in no uncertain terms. Kolodze out in front. A big 3 points.
Lindgren second.
A special kind of race mean to go and see. The first one of the year is always a booster. Davey Watt has gone all the way out there to check on.
He's doing great, you know. I can't wait to see him in meetings like this. You know, he'll be putting it about there for, I'm sure.
Okay, thanks for your views. Thanks, Davey.
Thank you.
Thanks indeed, Chris. And another Chris that's under a lot of pressure at the moment. Can he make it 2 wins in a row? Chris Harris really needs it if he wants to go through to the semi-finals. He's out now in heat 16 off of 3. Underneath him is Greg Hancock and Nicky Pedersen. It's a toughie. Antonio Limbuck is on the outside. Let's get back to the track and our commentators.
Antonio Lindbach back in the Grand Prix series tonight. He goes off the outside in yellow and has just got 1 point to his name. This is heat number 16. Two world champions. Hancock did it in 97. Pedersen's done it 3 times. Off the inside two gates. Heat 16 it is. And away from the start, it's a beauty by Pedersen off gate number two. Hancock locks up the inside line. Chris Harris is coming through in white. Chris Harris of Great Britain. Pedersen on the outside. All three abreast here. Hancock is taking Harris out wide. Pedersen says thank you very much. So does Lindbach. How close is this?
Fabulous stuff once again. What an open lap of speedway. Harris jumps back to the inside. Powering up the inside. Pedersen and Harris neck and neck as they go into turn three for the second time. Hancock's out in front, really looking strong. Harris and Pedersen battling hard. Lindbeck's not out of it. Terrific speedway.
Hancock's got the race under control and is heading through to the semi-finals, no doubt about that. Lindbeck working Harris hard now for that 1 point. Harris really needs to hang on if he's to maintain an interest in the race for a semi-final place. And Lindbeck is really working him up the inside line. Pedersen is second. This is the battle for third place, as you can see on his screen. Harris is just hanging on there. Hancock has got the race in the bag. No question about that. No mistake at all from Greg Hancock. Nicky Pedersen second. Chris Harris was third. More great speedway, and it just underlines.
Terrific.
It's not all about winning the race. Every point counts. That's why Harris worked so hard for third place.
Yeah, he did, and he was a little unfortunate not to have actually hung on to second place. Hancock, though, has been majestic out in front there, pulling away, showing a lot of speed. The other two boys were squabbling, and then that allowed him to pull away. Pedersen, though, scrapping hard, looking good for second place, keeping himself well and truly amongst the points for the Grand Prix. Hancock, though, what a night he's having, moving on to 11.
Brilliant from Greg Hancock now. He really is top of the pile on 11. Mickey Pedersen's on 8. It's a clutch of riders on 8. Harris on 5, and Lindback out of the picture now.
Any doubt that anyone had that the new FIM silencers would quash great racing? They're wrong. And cram their way into Lesno, but surprisingly, it's not quite full. Greg Hancock, though, doesn't care. 11 points for him. Emil Sifudinov on 9. Thomas Golob, Jonas Kolodzi and Nicky Pedersen all on 8, as is Freddie Lindgren as well. This is anybody's tromp all the way into the semi-final. Sam Ermolenko's...
That's it. Good luck. Thanks, Eric.
Yeah, thanks.
Heat number 17 then, Chris Holder going off the inside. He still needs points here. Gate 2 is Rune Holter, injured, but still riding well on 6. Lindback in gate 3. Sifudinov off the outside, should be safe for the semis. This is heat number 17 in Lesno, and it's a good start from Rune Holter in blue, but coming up the inside in red is Chris Holder, and what about that in the yellow helmet? Emil Sifudinov so very quick, and now charging around the outside is Rune Holter in blue. Chris Holder is the man in red. Third place now is Sifudinov, but Sifudinov is really putting pressure on Chris Holder. Great speedway again here.
Fabulous stuff. It looked like a sensational first corner from Sifudinov, but he's been outbound. Oh, Lindback almost in the back, in the side of Sifudinov as they enter the turn there. Holter, brilliant stuff down the back straight initially to get himself to the front, and looks good. Holder once again, consistent, hasn't won a race, but this will be another second place. On to 9 points, should be enough. Out in front, Holter looks good.
Yeah, if it stays like this, Rune Holter will finish on 9, so will Chris Holder. That should be enough, with Sifudinov getting a point here, that would be 10, but Lindback is still piling on the pressure at the back here, and Sifudinov is having to really work hard for a point here. The lead is with Rune Holter, fantastic ride from him. Second place was Chris Holder, third was Emil Sifudinov, Lindback at the back. And now it should mean that Holter and Sifudinov should all be through to the semi-finals.
And you've got to give that guy a lot of respect. He was very beaten up coming into this Grand Prix after a horrific accident on Monday in the league match in Rzeszów in the Polish league. Comes up with a vital win. So often you see it from him. He shows so much courage. Really does come good when the pressure's on.
Absolutely right. Rune Holter the winner, with Chris Holder second. Emil Sifudinov was third. Lindback at the back, and this is what it means overall. Sifudinov moves on to 10. Holter and Holder are on 9 points apiece. And as things stand, you would suggest that that should be enough for them.
Just hope there's no count.
In blue, Andreas Jonsson, not the best of nights for him. He's off gate 3. Hancock, Golub, Jonsson and Laguta. That's your lineup for heat number 18.
Well, it looks like a bit of a head-to-head between the two boys on the inside. Jonsson will probably now come up with a huge performance and do something spectacular from gate 3, but we've talked about gate 3, we've seen the stats about gate 3, and there's only been one winner from there so far this evening, so the odds are against the Swedish rider Jonsson coming out of there and doing anything. But even if he wins the race, he only goes to 7 points, and that may not be enough anyway.
No, won't be enough tonight.
No, and that's a disappointing opening round for the Grand Prix for the fancied Swede, when so much talk about him being fast in the early season races.
There's already 8 riders with 8 points or over.
Okay.
So that means that Jonsson can't qualify for the semi. Golub. What a ride that is from Golub. Thomas Golub, and now Greg Hancock on the inside, but Golub has got the high and wide line. Jonsson is charging hard to try and come through into second place, but Hancock holds the line superbly. Golub with the lead, Hancock second, and Jonsson is third.
Brilliant stuff from Thomas Golub. Just for a moment, I thought he might have gone too wide, but Golub is the master of that outside run. Good stuff going on for second and third. Jonsson looks like he's got a little bit more pace, but certainly the pace is all about that man in front. Hancock talked about starting in, so important to get your nose in front early in the race. We're seeing it here. Hancock only dropped 1 point, struggling to stay with Golub this time.
Absolutely right. Golub riding well here though, looking very impressive. You can't rule him out from winning the meeting, can you? He's capable of popping out and winning a race any time. There were question marks about Golub because of the fact that he hadn't raced competitively in Poland on the new silencers. He has tonight. He's had no problems at all. Golub is through to the semi-finals. So is Greg Hancock. Jonsson's night is over, but the reigning champion has just fired a message to his rivals. He's on form, and he is up for the challenge of an opening night win here.
Fabulous performance after that disappointing when he was so frustrated when he got excluded earlier on. The right decision, I believe, but certainly showing a lot of... well, that's why he's the champion. He's bounced back fantastic. He's on to 11 points and comfortably into the semi-finals.
Thomas Golub the winner, Greg Hancock second, Andreas Jonsson third. Laguta was trailing at the back. And Golub, when he stayed on his bike, has only dropped 1 point from four rides. And excluded in the other. Hancock 13 leads the GP. Golub second in the standings on 11. Saifuddinov 10. And as you can see, the top eight clear cut at the moment on 8. It can still change with two needs points here. Heat number 19 it is. Lindgren off the inside. Kenneth Pierre off 2. Jason Crump off 3. Nicky Pedersen off the outside. It's a mouth-watering lineup. This is heat number 19 of the European Speedway Grand Prix in Leszno here in Poland. The man in red there is Freddy Lindgren, has been left at the start. The lead is with Pierre. Now Lindgren comes up the inside. Charging through in yellow, though, is Nicky Pedersen. Fantastic stuff from the Dane. Jason Crump has been left at the back now, passed by Lindgren. A miserable night in the end for Jason Crump, who's working hard to try and pass Lindgren again. Lindgren looks as though he's got the pace to try and challenge Nicky Pedersen here. Here comes Lindgren in red. He's dived up the inside of Nicky Pedersen. Fantastic ride from the Swede. And now the lead is with Pierre. Lindgren is second. Crump has come through into third. Pedersen's returned the compliment.
Oh, great speedway. Once again, we're seeing Freddy Lindgren's got a lot of pace. And Pierre's got to look out, because look at Lindgren. Crump's up into third place. Pedersen back up the inside of Crump, back into third place. Look at Lindgren around the outside. Can he put pressure on Pierre? One lap to go. Can he get to the front?
Well, they're throwing the bike at each other. Lindgren has got the lead. Sensational stuff. I was watching Crump just take a
avoiding
action there. But Nicky Pedersen has got third. But Freddy Lindgren has gone from last to first. What has taken a fantastic win.
What a speedway race that was. Both of us looking at the action for third place between Pedersen and Crump. But what a performance from Freddy Lindgren. So much pace. Battled through into second place with one lap to go. Really hunted down Kenneth Pierre and found his way through to the front. That's the ride of the night for me, no doubt about that. Disappointment for Crump, no question. He's out of the Grand Prix. Pedersen scrapping for points.
Well, that was the equivalent to being beaten up on a motorbike, really, for Jason Crump. He was taken wide and it was sensational. But what about that win from Lindgren? Last to first. And he's level with Golub on 11.
Brilliant performance from Freddy Lindgren, no question. Yeah, that was 15 rounds of boxing we saw there between Pedersen and Crump. Crump did well.
Points here, he's on 5. But it's not going to be enough because those riders on 8 points will not make the semi-finals tonight. The semi-final race, almost clear cut. Jarek Campbell is on 6 so far, needs to win the race. So all the pressure on Jarek Hampel here, heat number 20. And away from the start, Hampel has made it one in wide. That is a dream start for Jarek Hampel. The man in red, Yanis Kolodze, is coming hard up the inside.
Harris!
What about that from Chris Harris in yellow, straight through the middle.
Fabulous stuff, look at Hampel and Harris pushing each other right out by the safety fence. Hampel somehow has got himself to the front. Kolodze back in the second, brilliant lap of speedway. Hampel around the outside, Kolodze settles in second place, Harris right for his life in third.
Well, this potentially is bad news for Chris Holder, because the win here for Jarek Hampel would put him on to 9, and Chris Holder, with no race win to his name, would dip out of the top 8. It would be heartbreak for Holder. Crash! He's caught the back wheel. That's high speed.
Kolodziej made a bad call there at the last moment, decides to switch. He's writhing around on the floor in pain. Big accident down the back street at high speed.
Well, that is one of those where the crowd hold their breath. That was at maximum speed, Kelvin, was it not?
Flat out down the back straight. Kolodziej decides to switch to the outside at the wrong moment, too late. Clips the back wheel of Jarek Hampel, who is an innocent party in this. Generating lots of speed as he comes off the banking. So much momentum. And there he goes across the track as Hampel's heading for the corner. High speed accident. Dramatic stuff.
Oh,
out of control.
Yeah.
The bike then clouts him on the way in. That really is a dramatic accident.
Well, let's just wish the man all the very best. Into the air fence. He does move straight away.
Probably the damage is done by the bike. The air fence is there. Of course, they always do a remarkable job. He's actually been
conscious.
He's conscious, which is good, but what a high-speed accident that was. Just one of those things. Hampel beginning to look for the third turn and coming back to the corner as Coloce had so much momentum and decided to, at the last minute.
Absolutely right. Jonas Coloce will be excluded from the restart then. And the landing was horrendous.
He bounces on the track and then the bike follows him in, and that's the problem. Let's just keep our fingers crossed that he can Grand Prix. Just what he wouldn't have wanted to happen. Would have had to stay away from, but certainly it's been terrific stuff so far.
If this is the start of things to come, you have to join us for the Speedway Grand Prix for the whole season. No rider off the inside, Belinsky off two, Hampel off three, and Chris Harris off the outside. Jarek Hampel needs a win. It's win or bust for Hampel here.
It is, and can he reproduce it again? The pressure's on the man in the white helmet colour.
Here we go then with heat number 20, and away from the start, Hampel has made a dream start once again for the second successive time. Harris switches up the inside line and has got that second spot. He's chasing hard now after Jarek Hampel. Third place is with Belinsky, the wild card. Harris goes high and wide and almost scrapes the fence, and Belinsky is putting him under pressure now. But Jarek Hampel has the lead, and if it stays like this, Hampel will move into the top eight, and Chris Holder will fail to qualify for the semi-finals on the countback.
Well, barring mechanical failure, you'd say that that's going to be the outcome here, because Hampel was brilliant again, once away from gate three, really showing good speed this time. Harris there made a mistake on the opening lap and very nearly lost second place to Belinsky. He will not be able to chase him down. Hampel has got stolen a march on him. Roaring high and wide, right up by the air fence. Spectacular stuff for the number two in the world. Started poorly tonight, but the last two rides, back-to-back wins.
Yep, down the back straight they go for the final time in heat 20, and Jarek Hampel has left it late, but it looks as though he's heading through to the semi-finals of the European Grand Prix. It's been a troubled night in many ways. Hampel had only got, 3 points from three rides, and it's heartache for Holder. He knows it.
Can't believe it, and I do have some sympathy there. He's done a charged hard all night. He was actually in front at one stage when the race was halted and he had to redo it, and Pierre managed to steal a march on him and win that race. Holder's out, Hampel is in.
Well, a sensational night of Speedway here, and here is the result of heat 20. Hampel, 3 points for him, Harris two, and Belinsky gets the point. Coloce thankfully walked away from a horrific incident there. What a night of Speedway here.
Concern. Hancock, Golob, Lindgren, Saifudinov, Pierre, Hampel, Holter and Pedersen all go through. But look at that, Chris Holder, luckless. Even though he scored 9 points, he's out of the semi-final. Let's go back to Chris Lewis then, who's at trackside live. At trackside.
First semi-final of the European Grand Prix then. Rune Holter going off the inside on 9. Greg Hancock, top of the pile so far on 13 off 2. Jarek Hampel, gate 3. After three straight wins to get through to the semis. And off the outside is Emil Seyfriedinov. A spectacular return to the Grand Prix scene for him tonight. Which two riders will head through to the first final of the season? Hancock has made a beautiful start off gate number 2. Hancock in blue. And now coming up the inside in white. Now that is a spectacular,
Hampel.
Spectacular ride for Jarek Hampel.
Oh, Seyfriedinov in the second place. What a first corner for the two youngsters. Hampel and Seyfriedinov charging through when Hancock had made such a good start. Hancock back to the inside. At the back, it's Rune Holter. He's struggling, but look at Hampel. Hampel has turned his night upside down. Started poorly with three third places. Flying out in front. He's going to the final.
He's hugely popular here in Leszno, there's no doubt about that. Emil Seyfriedinov is second, but look at Hancock winding it all on. Hancock's going to have a go now. He's going to go high and wide. Seyfriedinov holds the line, kicks out his right leg. The lead is with Hampel. One race to go. And Greg Hancock, the man who led the Grand Prix going into the semi-final, is on the verge of missing out unless he can pull off something very, very special. Past the young man Seyfriedinov, who's half Hancock's age. Not going to happen.
Hampel
is through.
and so is Saifuddinov. And what a fairy tale comeback in this meeting for Yara Campbell.
Three back-to-back wins in his last three rides. Brilliant stuff from the world number two. Excellent first corner. Hancock just went a little bit out of shape there, and the two youngsters steamed up the inside into first and second. Saifuddinov had to hang on a wee bit in the back end of the race with Hancock charging hard. But you've got to give Yara Campbell so much credit. Nowhere after three rides. Now he's in the final. Terrific.
Absolutely sensational. He's on 12 points now, Yara Campbell. So is Emil Saifuddinov. They go through. Hancock and Holter, their night is over. Hancock has to settle for 14 points in the first GP of the season. Campbell and Saifuddinov level on 12 apiece now. Holter finishes on 9. Remember, the final, your points count for double. A spectacular...
Chris Lewis, semi-final number 2 then comes up off the inside. Kenneth Pierre, Thomas Golob alongside him, Freddie Lindgren off 3, and Nicky Pedersen off the outside. Somewhat fortunate, perhaps, to get a place like the outside of the gate. Freddie Lindgren opting to go for that gate 3 white-helmeted position. Thomas Golob going off of blue, which seems to be the favourite of the night. Kenneth Pierre getting the inside line then. So then, as they come to the tapes, let's go back to our commentators.
Join Yara Campbell and Emil Saifuddinov in the final of the European Grand Prix. Golob has made a beautiful start, but Pedersen leans on him in yellow. Here comes Freddie Lindgren as well. It's all very tight down the back straight. Lindgren is going high and wide to the fence.
Oh, down.
Down goes Freddie Lindgren. The red lights will have to come on, and I suspect Lindgren's night will be over with that crash.
He was charging down the outside of Thomas Golob, and there was never going to be any room to go around Golob. He was going to go for the dirt. What an effort that was from Nicky Pedersen coming from the outside. Pedersen so determined away from the tape. Just coming here on the outside. No room to go in there for Freddie Lindgren. He slips off the motorbike and gets jammed underneath the air fence. That's a bit of disappointment for the Swede when he's been so impressive tonight. Golob switching to the outside, and Lindgren just were left with nowhere to go.
Yep, Freddie Lindgren is the man to be disqualified from the restart. And what a shame for him after such a terrific
blow. He looked like he had the speed to win tonight. And just, you know, those split-second decisions, it just went against him there. He'll be really disappointed. Good to see him up and about, of course. High-speed accident, just sliding off the bike at the end of the back straight. But on the evidence of his performance so far tonight, he could have a major part to play in this year's championship.
Well, his target is a top 5 place this year, Freddie Lindgren. If he can maintain this type of consistency, he'll be absolutely devastated.
Two of these three are going through to the semi-final. Let's cross back then to trackside and pick up with Kelvin and Nigel.
Off the inside, Golob off 2, no rider off 3. Nicky Pedersen is going to go off the outside here. And it's the second semi-final. So far, we know already that Yara Campbell and Emil Saifuddinov are through to the final. And Emil studying the opposition for the final. Two of these three will be in the final of the European Grand Prix here in Leszno. Second semi-final, here we go again. Golob's made a good start off gate number 2, not for the first time tonight. Now Pedersen locks up the inside. Pedersen has come through, and now it's getting all very tight down the back straight. Golob has returned the compliment. Great ride from Thomas Golob. Nicky Pedersen is second, Kenneth Pierre is third, and Golob is kicking on here now.
Brilliant stuff once again from Pedersen. Got to give him a lot of credit. He made a really smart move there to switch back to the inside to make sure he didn't get shoved too wide. Golob majestic once again out in front. Pierre's the danger man. He's not out of this. Pedersen's really going to have to wind it on because Pierre's charging hard in third place. But Golob, you can't deny the man, the world champion, out in front, looking good for the final.
Well, no problems with the new silencers for Thomas Golob tonight, that's for sure. He is making light work of this semi-final. Got the lead. Nicky Pedersen, he'd be delighted to reach the final. He really is looking very quick tonight, Nicky Pedersen. Kenneth Pierre is third. Looks like his night is going to end here with a consolation point to add to his total. Thomas Golob, the reigning world champion, has reached the final of the first Grand Prix of the year.
Golob's got stronger as the night's gone on, no question about it. Celebrates with a big wheelie in the second semi-final, cruises through to the final. Pedersen scrapping hard, looking good, charging in second place. Disappointment for Pierre back in third place, but the world champion, what a performance. Bitterly disappointed to be excluded earlier on, but has come back in fine style. And certainly he's only dropped 1 point since that exclusion. Cruises into the big final. Can he win tonight?
Well, he's gone joint top of the meeting on 14 points now, level with Greg Hancock. And Hancock's night is over, remember. Gollop, 3 points. Pedersen, 2. They're both through to the final. Bjerre and Lindgren have ended their evening with that race. Gollop, as we said, level with Hancock at the top of the leaderboard. Lindgren and Pedersen on 11. Kenneth Bjerre on 10.
Dramatic Grand Prix. Even the silencers couldn't be a problem for the opening Grand Prix of the year. Let's go back to the track then and our commentators.
Here's the lineup there, the mouth-watering lineup it is as well. Emil Seyfudinov with 3 Grand Prix wins to his name. Tomasz Golub with 20 Grand Prix wins to his name. Jarre Kampel is off gate number 3. He's only won 1 Grand Prix, and Nicky Pedersen goes off the outside with 11 Grand Prix wins to his name.
Yeah, it's remarkable that Hampel's only won 1 Grand Prix. You know, he's better than that, and he hasn't managed to really seal the deal on many occasions. He's had some terrific performances. Of course, he slipped out of the Grand Prix for some time and then battled his way back in, and then all of a sudden he's really is now become a true world-class performer. Big racing prospect.
First final of the year here in Leszno, the European Grand Prix, and Tomasz Golub has made a dream start off gate 2. Pedersen up the inside in yellow. Pedersen, he's going to take him wide. Surely there's no room. Golub stays on the bike.
Unbelievable stuff down the back straight. Golub nearly off the back of the bike. Seyfudinov in second place. Golub back into third place. Pedersen's away. Golub now in his second place. Unbelievable first lap from the world champion, but Pedersen scrapping, battling, so eager to get to the front.
Coming through into second now is Seyfudinov, but Golub returns the compliment. Hampel is at the back, 2 laps gone. Pedersen has got the lead. Golub is angry, he's wound up, he's turning the screw, he's going to try and get as close to Pedersen as he can. It was tough, it was hard, it was grueling down the back straight, but Nicky Pedersen of Denmark is going into lap 3 ahead of the final.
Oh, at the back, Seyfudinov and Hampel nearly come together, but Pedersen's got this. He's away with it. What a performance from the 3-time champion.
Nicky Pedersen, who's returned to British Speedway in 2011, has started the season with a victory in the European Grand Prix. Tomasz Golub, the reigning champion, has to settle for second spot. That was vintage Pedersen. It was tough. No quarter asked or given. But the great Dane, Nicky Pedersen, he's back!
Fabulous performance from Nicky Pedersen. I tell you what, I would not have picked him for a winner before tonight's action started. But you've got to give the man a lot of credit. He's had 2 years in the wilderness. He's had injuries. He's had frustration. We've seen all sorts of antics from Nicky Pedersen in the last couple of years. But what a performance from him.
Nigel Pearson said it all. Nicky Pedersen came back to the British Elite League and he has started his Grand Prix campaign in the best possible way. Maximum points for the Great Dane. He takes them here at Leszno. What a superb finish. You've got to say that the 3 men behind him have spent fighting and maybe just let Nicky Pedersen off the hook at the front of the field, but you've got to make it work for you. Pedersen takes the win from Tomasz Golub then. Emil Seyfudinov is back on the podium of the Grand Prix with Jarek Hampel finishing in fourth place. And that's how they finished points-wise after race 1.